slave labor camp at Nordhausen, liberated by the 3rd Armored Division, 1st Army. At least 3,000 political prisoners died here at the brutal hands of SS troops and pardoned German criminals who were the camp guards. Nordhausen had been a depository for slaves found unfit for work in the underground V-bomb plants and in other German camps and factories. American medical crews find 2,000 still alive at the camp. They are discovered inside filthy barracks where the survival and death were contingent on how long human existence was possible on the daily ration of potato peels, one slice of bread, and an occasional bowl of a liquid that was supposedly soup. The dead quickly outnumbered the living. Amid the corpses are human skeletons too weak to move. Men of our medical battalions work 2 days and nights binding wounds and giving medications. But for advanced cases of starvation and tuberculosis, there are often no cures. The survivors are shown being evacuated for treatment in Allied hospitals. The victims are mainly Poles and Russians, with considerable numbers of French and other nationalities also included in the camp roster. The Bürgermeister of Nordhausen is ordered to provide 600 German male civilians who will inter the 2,500 unburied bodies at the camp. The priest administers last rites for the dead while the corpses are being carried to the hillside for burial. All day long, the German civilians carry the gruesome corpses, some of which are already green and putrefied. Then, the actual burial in common graves of the 2,500 Nordhausen victims.